What's the perfect font size? Is there a perfect font size? Maybe that question would be a lot easier to answer if we had just one medium for reading and experiencing typography, but with all of our varying devices and screen sizes these days, the best, most optimal font size is not a pixel measurement, or an M, even rem. Rather, the perfect font size is... Hey friends, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey, and I'm a web designer from Canada. Today we're going to learn how to create the perfect font size for any screen, device, or breakpoint using Editor X. In fact, go to editorx.com, sign up for free, start a fresh site, and try this out with me. Here's an example of standard heading text with a font size of 42 pixels. The problem with this is it's not responsive. So when I view it on a smaller screen or resize my window, the text is still 42 pixels. And the screen to text ratio is unbalanced and it kind of looks terrible on the screen. So let's start with a very basic typography science lesson, shall we? What's the optimal font size ratio? Well, there's a ton of opinions on this, but my opinion is that my opinion is the best. This website, type-scale.com, gives us some options for font ratios. And I like the golden ratio because, well, Leonardo da Vinci believed that basically everything in this world, from nature to anatomy to the stars in the skies, blah, 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 can be reduced down to this ratio. Now, he didn't have an iPhone or Wikipedia, drones or Google Maps, so who knows how correct he was. I mean, you can't blame the guy. He couldn't ask AI for all the answers. What was I saying? Right, golden ratio. It's 1.618. Old Leo D called it divina proportione, or the divine proportion. So, if this number truly came from God, then clearly this is the best way to size your fonts. You can't argue with that. So, we use that number. Basically means take your base font size. Let's go with 14 pixels, for example. Now, simply multiply your base font size by the golden ratio to create the next font size up. Multiply that font size by the golden ratio and you get the next font size up from there, and so on so forth. So if you need smaller font sizes, well, you probably guessed it, you divide by the golden ratio. So using type-scale.com, let's come up with our font sizes using this golden ratio. So we've got our golden ratio font sizes, but the problem is, if we plug these font sizes into our website as is, they're still static. And we have to change these font sizes for each breakpoint to make them look good on smaller screens. So, what is the optimal font size for smaller devices? Again, all we gotta do is ask the internet, and we'll get probably the truth. So, based on what I inherently know, just from my own experience and wisdom, it looks like the most readable font size is around 16 to 18 pixels for body copy. And if we're using the divina proportione, or golden ratio, we'll multiply that by 1.618 to get our next heading size up, which would be about 26 to 29 pixels. Now, I prefer when there's dramatic contrast between headings and body copy, so I'll go ahead and multiply the gold by the golden ratio a couple of times. Now, that gets us 76 pixels. Now, if I were to do this in CSS and I was like a trad web designer, we'd use media queries to adjust the font size based on breakpoints. Now, if I were to take this no code route and do this in Editor X, I would add the font size, change the breakpoint, and then update the font sizes individually for each breakpoint. But the user experience can be a little bit choppy as you resize the window. And the typography will make awkward jumps to the new font size at each breakpoint. Now, to reduce this clunkiness, I could add multiple custom breakpoints in Editor X, but that adds some complexity to my design process, and it creates potential for me to mess something up along the way, along one of the breakpoints. Besides, it's just a little bit hacky, if you know what I mean. So this is where scale text comes in handy. When you click on a text element, a little pop-up appears for you to style and customize your text. Right beside font size is a little icon. It's called scale text. Click that to turn it on. It's a simple feature with two inputs, which can be a bit confusing at first. Is it some sort of math formula or function? What do these inputs mean? Well, while I agree that it is a little bit confusing, and hey, Editor X team, a simple label or tooltip explaining what these mean could go a long way to helping out the newbies. It actually is a very simple idea once you know what these inputs mean. You ready? The left input is your minimum font size. So the smallest font size for this element that you want to see on your smallest breakpoint. So phones. And the right input is the maximum font size, what you want to see on your largest breakpoint. So desktops. Now, if we go back to our mini font science lesson and choose the perfect minimum font size for this heading element, we're going to say something like 29 pixels. And in this example, I want the maximum font size. I'm going to go with something like 520 pixels, which is a multiple of our golden ratio. Now, we can resize our window, and this font perfectly scales as if it were liquid at any screen size, breakpoint, and everything in between, with our minimum and maximum font sizes as creative constraints. One of my favorite Editor X features is the ability to save any element or designed component as an asset to my site library for later use or for sharing with other people like team members or collaborators. Now, if I save this typography element as an asset to my site library, does scale text transfer over into that asset? Let's try that out. Yep, it does. And this is just one of the many impressive things that Editor X can do for you as a professional designer or agency owner. And if you'd like to learn how to build amazing websites and grow your business with Editor X as your new favorite no-code platform, watch this series right here. Also, join us in the Creative X crew, my free community of designers, agency founders, freelancers, and no-code makers. We host weekly office hours, workshops, expert interviews, challenges. We give you feedback on your work. A free invite link is in the description below, and I'll see you in the next one, friends.